Hello, my dear friends. Your host, Shurma here. A very warm welcome to you all, and I'm so glad you chose to spend some time with me today. I have a fun project to share with you. I would be painting some purple and pink flowers in one stroke style, and then I would be turning it into something very useful. So stick around with me. Here is the list of materials which I would be using today. So let's dive into chapter number 1, that is preparing the backdrop for the flower painting. For starters, I have a couple of elements with me which I have already created. So the first element is a box card which I have created with the help of printed paper and chipboard, and you can see the spine of the card, and it is around 4 inches by 6.5 inches in size. The next piece is a white watercolor paper. It is around 2.5 inches by 5.5 inches in size. The third element is a black printed paper, and I have cut out a window from the left side of the paper, and it fits just over the white watercolor paper. Next, I am going to create a background on the white watercolor paper, and I have kept it on an absorbent piece of paper. And here I am using certain green watercolors, ranging from light to dark, and I'm using a water spray to spread the color on the paper layer by layer. This is a very organic background, and it turns out different every time I do it. So I really love these kind of backgrounds. So once done, I leave it to dry. That takes us to chapter number 2, that is painting the purple and pink flowers in one stroke style on this particular background paper. So here is the palette. Pink acrylic color, then comes deep magenta, purple and permanent rose acrylic color along with white acrylic. I have a flat brush number 6 in hand. I'm loading it with permanent rose, pink and deep magenta and a bit of white acrylic. It creates a beautiful mix of colors, and here, because I've used 4 colors, so this is multiple loading of the brush, and this is the speciality of one stroke style of painting. Next, I turn the paper upside down. And then I pick up a flat brush number 4 with permanent rose on it, and I'm creating a very loose form of a rose flower. Next, I go ahead and add a bit of deep magenta and a bit of purple on it. Next, I go ahead and pick up my flat brush number 6, and it is loaded with permanent rose, pink and white at this point of time. So only 3 colors, as you can see over here. So I begin with the first layer of the petals of the first rose, and I'm calling this as the pink rose. And the technique is one stroke style. So this is the one stroke rose flower in the making. Painting flowers is my passion since childhood, and I totally agree with Ralph Waldo Emerson when he says that the earth laughs in flowers. Actually, the relationship between humans and flowers has always been special. Humans have always been strangely attracted to flowers, even when they do not provide any physical sustenance to humankind. The attraction is not on a survival level, but it goes beyond that. Well, at this point, I have started working on the purple rose flower, and here I am using a flat brush number 4 along with purple and deep magenta to create a loose form of the flower. And then I go ahead and use my flat brush number 6 and load it with purple and white to create the petals of the rose flower. So as I was saying, that flowers are a multi-sensory experience that includes smell, texture, color, etc. Flowers activate multiple parts of our brain, creating a stimulating and perceptual experience. We tend to flowers as we tend to our loved ones. The aesthetic experience becomes socially embedded and relational. Don't you agree? And this, in turn, leads to the awesome experience of feeling connected positively to the world. It is said that flowers are like friends. They bring color to the world. And where flowers bloom, so does hope, says Lady Bird Johnson. And yes, as Henry Matisse said, there are always flowers for those who want to see them. Well, here I'm trying to give some final touches to the purple rose, and I'm using the corner of the brush and white acrylic to create highlights. Once the purple and pink flowers are done, I go on to create the leaves. And that brings us to chapter number 3. Here comes the palette. I have purple acrylic color, light blue, sap green, and olive, as well as white acrylic. And I have a flat brush number 6, which I am loading with sap green and white. I'm blending the colors well. I again go ahead and add a bit of olive green to the mix, so this is triple loading of the brush. You need to blend all the colors very well for great results. Next, I go ahead and bring in my liner brush, and I've loaded it with purple, and I'm just trying to create a bit of purple background along the edges of the pink flower. Next, I bring in the light blue acrylic color over the purple flower. More of purple. Here I have a bit of blue, and then comes sap green. More of sap green along the edges of the purple flower. Once I'm happy with the background creation, I go ahead and pick up my flat brush number 6, and I have loaded it with sap green, olive green, and white, and I start creating the pretty one-stroke style of leaves. Are you enjoying the painting so far? And if you would like to know more about one stroke style of painting, and for my returning viewers, if you would like to refresh your leaf and stroke skills, then I would encourage you to visit my past videos, and I would be very happy to drop some of the links in the description box below. And here you can also click on the I button, which appears on the right hand side of this particular screen, and this will also lead you to some of those tutorials which deal with one stroke style of painting. This particular leaf has a bit of purple to the mix of green and white. Hence you see it looks different as compared to the other leaves. There you go, I have added some light blue to it as well. And it changes the leaf so much. Do you agree? And do you like what you see? Do let me know in the comment box below. I love to read your reactions and responses, and it gives me an insight into your understanding and your perception of the painting. In case you have certain queries or even suggestions about one stroke style of painting, please feel free to drop them in the comment box below, and I would be very pleased to respond to all of them. Well, at this point, I went ahead and picked up my liner brush along with yellow acrylic color, and I'm trying to create the flower centers, and that completes the panel. Next comes completion of the project. Well, now these are the elements which I have. I'll go over them once again for you. The first being the box card base, the second is the painted panel, the third one is the window which I created using the printed black paper, and there are some gold glitter strips, very thin ones, and I have put them all together to create this particular thing, which is actually a cell phone holder. I'm sure you're surprised, right? Well, here I've created a plastic pocket, and the cell phone snugly sits in that pocket. That is the back side of the box card holder, and this is the front. So as you see, my pink and purple flowers adorn the cover of my handmade cell phone holder. Did you enjoy watching me create the purple and pink flowers in one stroke style of painting? Also, do you appreciate the usefulness of this project? And if yes, then hope you will also try your hand at it. Do let me know in the comment box below. I would be waiting to hear from you. Also, please connect with me on my social media handles, and it would be a great pleasure to be in touch with you. Thank you from the bottom of my heart for all the support and love you show to my channel, and I'm really, really grateful for that. And as always, thanks for watching. We'll be back very soon with more floral painting video tutorials. Till then, stay tuned, take care of yourself, and bye-bye.